It's been 5 years since I moved to Barcelona. That's 260 Saturdays missed. 260 Saturdays that I'm left dreaming about the bags of chips so soggy that you'd have to run back to your spot before the bag split. 260 Saturdays where no matter where I am, I'm only half present, as the other half of me drifts away down a headphone. It's gotten to the point where if I see a seagull devouring a dead pigeon, I'm actually moved by it, as it reminds me of where I should be. In the time I've lived in Barcelona, I've co-written and starred in an award-winning comedy series where I snuck as much Torquay United memorabilia into the shot as possible. I've even hosted a radio show and worked on a 20-minute stand-up routine about ducks. I'm almost 27 years old. I'm supposed to be a man. But I still find myself recreating the 2003-2004 promotion season on my PlayStation 2, collecting pictures of old players like how I used to collect Pokemon cards, and looking on eBay once a day to see if my favourite shirt has appeared in small men's size. No dice. When I kick a grain of rice along the floor, I'll shout,
"Graham!"
Whilst aiming to get it into a small hole next to the washing machine. I thought by leaving the country, I'd probably end up losing my feelings for my beloved yellows, but I still well up like a pathetic moron when I hear Children by Robert Miles. I constantly wonder why I'm always revelling in memories at Playmore, so maybe I should just ask the experts about why I'm so hooked.
Joseph this time, he's beaten him for pace, he's got Britain in the middle, if he can deliver the cross, doesn't need to.
Today, I'll be talking with
Ben Gerring. Yes, Ben Gerring, pantomime villain and all that stuff. Ex-Gull, currently playing for Woking. He had a good 2 year spell with the club, and then, safe to say, things turned a little bit sour. So let's see what Ben has to bloody say about that. Hello!
Hello, mate.
Hello, Ben. How are you doing, mate?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm very good. Is that sunny Torquay, or where are you?
Yeah, sunny Torquay.
Why am I, as a 27-year-old man boy, so hooked to Torquay United? I've got Barcelona here. I've got FC Barcelona. I've been to see them a few times. It's been brilliant, but it's not the same as Torquay United. Why am I so hooked?
Playing was infectious.
Right now it is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Hello, chap. How you doing?
I think it's just infectious. And the point being, it's a professional club, so it's a good standard of football, and it's your hometown. So I think I'd be the same. I think I'd still follow Torquay if I was to move away. And believe it or not, I still follow them. They're the first result I look for.
Yeah, of course.
Okay. So it's the first result. And I think it is, you take away, any sort of badge that's got Prem label to it, that's, kind of common to everybody else. You put the Torquay badge on and it's home, isn't it?
So no,
you're doing it because wherever you're travelling, you're taking a piece of home with you.
I get to see 3 or 4 games a season and I build it up so much, but when I get to Playmore, I'm a little bit disappointed still. You know what I mean? I build it up so much in my head, and then it's like, oh God, I've returned to the home of the idiots. Because you got to admit, a lot of Torquay fans, questionable mental states.
They're deluded.
Some of them
really do need to just remember where the club's at, the calibre of players it's got representing them, and if they could kind of reflect that on their behaviour, it probably would bring a few more through the gate. But it just seems like they're getting so many bans and stuff still. But the problem being that these older generations are setting the standard for the younger lads. So I'm talking this year, probably start of February. I went to watch, it might be in January actually, but I went to watch a midweek game. And I just went with me and another lad, got in the car, went past the, the McCalls?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I went past McCalls and there must have been about 9, I wouldn't put them over 17, 18.
Hoodlums.
9, 17. Yeah, one of them clocked me and then,
oh God,
just started hurling abuse at me. And I laugh it off, but it just goes like a bit further on. If you've got those people that are inside the ground, can go the opposite way, I think.
Where do you opt to go when you go into the ground? What stand are you in?
Bristow's, yeah.
Of course, mate. Most intelligent spot, that. Most intelligent spot. All right, Ben.
I think if I was to be seen in the pop side, I don't know how that would go.
You'd be very brave. Is brave the word? I'm not sure if brave is the word there, if you ended up there, but...
Foolish.
Can you describe Torquay United in one sentence? You've got... use about 10 words.
I've got 10 words. I've got to describe Torquay United. This will be a good one. Just a phrase, then. The club I love to hate.
Oh, all right. Take that.
The club I love to hate. Because... Just to summarise why I say the club I love to hate, because I do love the club,
yeah.
But I've got to show an element of hate there, because one, they let me go,
yeah,
and two, it adds to the fun. In all honesty, like, it's not real hate. It's not a genuine hate, but it's a club that I love to hate. I enjoy the wind-ups. I enjoyed my time there. I enjoyed everything, but there's a couple of things from the club that, like I say, they let me go, they released me, maybe didn't play me as much as I should have been. So yeah, I'd say the club I love to hate.
So, on that topic of leaving, how did that happen? Were you happy at the club at that point?
I was happy to a certain degree, but it was tough times financially for the club. So. You know, it's not as if I was leaving a lucrative deal, yeah, that way.
Right, okay.
I think my partner was literally a matter of a few months away from delivering. And when I said, I'd probably say in the next 4 to 6 weeks. We just had Charlie. So we had Charlie in March. I got released in June, maybe. It come about, I think it was a tough decision for Nicholson. I genuinely don't believe he enjoyed it. But I think he just had a different type of defender to what I was, to put it bluntly. I like to mess around. I like to joke. I love the dressing room. I like to kind of be that relaxed guy around the place. And I think Nicholson was a lot more professional, I suppose, would be the word, than I was.
Right. So you were the joker, you were essentially.
Yeah, I was the joker. And I think if, what was I? I would have been 26 when I got released. So I think if I was to demonstrate a little bit more of the professional side and less of the joker side, I think you'd get me.
I think it's all about the balance, though, isn't it? Like you said, you're entitled to joke around a bit, but how far did you take it, Ben?
Well, the problem I had, or the problem Nicholson had, is we had a double of me and Brett Williams. So me and Brett together,
yeah.
It was a problem. But yeah, I think if I'd swung it from sort of... I mean, it was at the end of the day, you don't want to put too much of a jokey side on it, because we had two relegation scraps, two serious relegation scraps. I mean, I see grown men cry. You know, that's how important it was to Torquay United and not to lose. And one thing I will always be proud of is I injected Torbay into that dressing room. There's no coming away from the fact that I injected a bit of that passion into the dressing room. I fell out with lots of people at the start. But I had to get my point across that this town, you know, deserves better. And we got the job done, effectively. So I think more towards the end of my stint there, I was more used in the dressing room. You know, they had to recall me from my loan, because I think as soon as I went out on loan, I think the dressing room just went to pot after a loss.
Right.
So the message was to come back. Believe it or not, the message I got was to come back and kind of pick everybody up. And it was... only till I maybe left Torquay, close to about 27, 28, that I managed to, you know, go to Woking. And I think I was kind of cemented there. It was 70% professional and it was 30% joker.
So the balance had opened up for you to take the piss a bit more.
Yeah.
And have fun, right, yeah.
Once, once you've got that respect and once you've got that kind of platform where the ball, everybody in the dressing room kind of sees what you're doing on the pitch, it allows you to kind of, you know, maybe have more of an input in the dressing room. If you're completely seen as pissing around, it's just one big joke and you're not trying hard enough on a Saturday, then it can go the complete opposite way. And that certainly didn't happen at Torquay. I don't think I ever come away from a Torquay game thinking, oh, I've cost us there or I wasn't good enough. Just generally thinking, at the time, I think Nicholson was made more professional than what I was ready to be. And at 24, I think, you know, there's no excuses there. So that would be the reason why I think he kind of moved me on. Not because of my ability or, you know, what I brought to the table. I just generally thought it was because he had, when he chose his DNA of a player that he wanted to sign, they all had one thing in common. They were all excellent in the gym. And unfortunately, I wasn't.
Don't worry, I'm completely with you on that one, Ben. Do not worry. I did 40 press-ups last Saturday, and that's it for the week.
That's it, you. It's your done, yeah?
Yeah, no, that's it, mate. Yeah, you should see the Swans, mate. They're absolutely sick. But
40 press-ups. That's good though.
Thank you very much. I like to think so myself, but my girlfriend is not that impressed either. So what would you like to do in the change when they recalled you from that loan and they said, right, Ben, come back, we're missing your jokes, you're bloody funny man. How would you joke about what? I said Ben, you're a bloody funny man. We need you back in the dressing room. What was your routine? What were you doing in the changing rooms? Did you have a little monologue prepared? What type of jokes would you go for? One-liners?
No, I wouldn't chuck jokes in there. I think it just came off the cuff. I think it was mood lighteners, really. I think it'd always be when Nicholson's out the room, like he would come in, say his bit. It'd be very, you know, you see everybody's shoulders are tense.
And then you do like a fart or something like that.
It could be something like that. Honest to God, it could be something like a fart. It could be something that is completely off topic. But I'll just chuck it out there, and then we just all, everybody would absorb all the information and then let it go. You know what I mean? Just, and I think that worked. I think, you know, people can't be uptight, especially in relegation battles. I think, you know, every week was so important. We just, I just took the approach was let's kind of keep the dressing room tight. It was only small anyway. You know, when we got outside, it was always competitive, but inside it was, you know, show your personality, show your colours, let's see what you're about. And if you were seen to be hiding, I'd expose you. I'd find you.
Do you remember your chant?
Yeah.
So we'll move on from that one, Ben. All right. Yeah. What's your weirdest fan interaction?
My weirdest fan interaction?
Yeah.
Shit. What I have done is I sold. What was it for? So that we've got German following.
Right, okay.
they're not German. They're Dutch.
Right, okay, right, yeah. Well, they're massive English football fans, the Dutch, aren't they?
Yeah, they're brilliant. But I've never actually met them, but they come to a lot of games. They fly over. And they paid over £600 for a charity, Strep B, for one of my friends' daughters that actually passed away from Strep B. So they took my match boots for 600 in the playoff final for £600. That was a good interaction, but it was strange because I never met these people. They just forked out £600.
Your greatest memory from Plainmoor?
My greatest memory from Plainmoor. Do you know what? I would go Forest Green at home.
The 4-1 win.
4-3. We were 3-0 up. Absolutely cruising the team that went on to win it or get promoted. Yeah, that was it. Got promoted, then they behind Lincoln, and then I've scored the winner. That would be my greatest moment there.
Your funniest memory, Ben?
My funniest memory. Oh,
that you're willing to share.
Training ground routine. I've spoken about this publicly before as well. So again, going back to me and Brett, they just called me back off loan. I believe we had Lincoln on Saturday, who were obviously flying. And he called me back off loan from Western Supermare. So I turned up to the training ground. Me and Brett had kind of seen each other. And the groundsman had just got off his petrol grass cutter. You know, you sit on drive and it cuts your grass.
Yeah.
So he left that running.
Oh,
so
we
both sprinted over. He's jumped on the front. I've jumped on the back. And we started donating this big lawnmower. And you've got the groundsman chasing us around the training ground. That was funny. I've literally got off. And then all I've heard was, "Gaz!" And I thought, oh, shit. So it's Nicholson calling me in to his office.
Oh, you idiot. You absolute idiot.
Literally, I'm talking 15, I would go, honestly, 15 seconds since I got off that lawnmower. And he calls me and I thought, he's seen the whole lot. I thought, that's me done. That's me finished. So he said, I called you back in off loan and need you this and the other. He said, I want you to come in. No more messing around with Brett Williams. You know, make sure you... I just thought he hasn't even seen. Oh my God.
So, did it get back to him? Did that get back to him, did that?
I told him in the gym. I actually told him this year, I told him. I think it was January, early Jan. He trains at Winners, so I've done the interview for the non-league where I kind of spoke about that. So I thought I'd tell him before he reads it.
Bloody
hell. He just shook his head. Shook his head and laughed, but I think it was more like a sum you up.
Yeah. Well, Ben, I'm gonna ask you to try and make me laugh.
Oh, I can't make you laugh.
Have you got a joke up in those short sleeves?
Have I got a joke? I got told one yesterday. What was it? Leanne, you got any jokes?
You've made me laugh. You've got me. Can you do a fan voice? You know, the sort of voice that imitates a whole crowd?
A fan voice?
Yeah, like try and imitate an entire crowd.
Without everybody thinking I'm weird.
There we are, mate. That's it. Yeah, you'll have to do it in front of your wife and kids at the minute.
So I've got to imitate a crowd.
An entire crowd. Yeah. Maybe singing the song of your choice. It could be Yellow Army. It could be whatever.
Oh, Ben Gerring. I need to find the guy who made that. You know. I need to find how he's just got that so arrhythmic, like it just goes, doesn't it? And it actually seems like it's been a song forever and it's going to stick, which annoys me.
How's your life now and your plans for the future?
My life is very content at the moment. I love my football, I love my football club. It's given me the buzz back for it again, being around really good people. And that spills out into the car business. The car business is doing well. Like I say, it's in its second year now. You know, and I always thought I'm that kind of person that can't even run a bath, let alone a business on my own. So really chuffed with that. That's kind of sustained itself. Family's growing. Wedding's booked. I would say I've got a platform there to really push on into my 30s and just enjoy. I think the next 5-year plan really looks good.
No, mate, I'm chuffed for you. That all sounds great. All sounds absolutely brilliant. And maybe from where you were a few years back, tables turned completely then.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, no. I think I've been released plenty of times. It's not something that I'm kind of new to. And I think, you know, when I was 20 and got released, was an idiot. You know, I just wasted 4 years. But once I got released from Torquay, I was okay with it. I mean, I knew my self-worth. I knew what I could bring to the table. Hello. So I just learned a massive lesson, which is football's a matter of opinions.
Yeah.
One man's opinion doesn't mean it's the thought of somebody else. Like, every single manager has a DNA of a player, a philosophy, and you will fit in somewhere. So, like I say, that kind of happened for me and quite quickly because, you know, I took a year at Truro and then moved on to a couple of decent clubs, and here I am fighting away. So I would say, yeah, enjoying that from that side of things, and probably did help me grow up a little bit.
Obviously, I'm out here in Barcelona. I've been working on all my comedy stuff and all that, and my partner, who I work with, is absolutely fascinated by Torquay United. And he sent you a question yesterday. Do you remember the question?
Hello, Ben Gerring. We all know you're such a cool guy. And this is my question for you. In the last game you played against Torquay United, were you drinking single plot, Ben Gerring?
Was I drinking blood of a seagull?
I think that's the question, yeah.
Do I answer it yes or no?
I think it's a yes or no question, mate, to be honest with you, yeah.
Was I drinking seagull blood? I'm going to answer no.
Good, right.
I feel like that's the end.
That's what I told him, mate. That's exactly what I told him, but he would not listen. All right, Ben. Well, is there any message for the Torquay fans?
See you soon.
See you soon. Cheers, Ben. Thank you very much. I'll send this across to you, mate. Thank you very much.
Cheers, buddy.
Cheers, man.
Bye.
Bye-bye.